in this edition of Thanks for the Memories, we feature the seventh son of a seventh son. That formula long thought to be a lucky one, and it was a lucky one, or if it hadn't been, today the great entertainer we're about to talk to would have been a great barber. Speaking of Perry Como, how are you today, Mr. Como?
Fine, Jim. How are you?
Fine, thank you. Is that true? You would have been a barber?
Well, I was until I was, until I was about 21, I guess.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I worked at it. It was an honest living.
Any special designs that you like to use on people?
I could have a ball today, couldn't I? They write their initials on their head. No, we didn't have that. We put a bowl on and cut around it, you know.
And you called yourself a barber, then, not a hairstylist, right?
Yeah, the difference is today they get $25. We used to get 25 cents.
Yeah.
But times were different, Jim, you know.
A year ago, this month, you recorded an album called Today.
Yeah.
And it's a great album. Who picked the songs for that album?
Well, it's kind of worked out between Mr. Perito, who was the conductor, and also on this, he was an A&R man. And he produced the album, and he conducted the band. He did everything but sing, and I wanted him to do that, but he wouldn't do it. But anyway, he and I get together, and I think, he wrote three of the songs.
Yeah?
Yeah. He wrote one with Dick Williams, who is Andy's brother. I think it's a good album.
It is a
way about it. I think it's some good songs in there.
What's it like recording? You've recorded on the 78 RPM records and now recording on a compact disc.
Well, they do that, Jim. You know, we do like we do any other record. Then they put it in digital and so on. But we have nothing to do with that, really.
Mm-hmm.
But I think it's a better sound.
Oh, yes.
It's a clear and no scratching, no hissing. Yes, it's a good development.
Oh, it's a sin to catch a butterfly, so I won't ever try to keep you in a jar. I'll just let you flip and float around. I'll never tie you down, 'cause that's the way you are. But once in a while, please fly home to me. All the snow has melted from the ground. When you first came around and held me, it was spring. April showers kept you here with me. Was it your love for me or water on your wings? Butterfly, I'll set you free, but once in a while, please make love to me. Catch a butterfly, so I'll just say goodbye and watch you fly away. But should you feel the bite of where this chill, come to my windowsill, I'll never make you stay. A butterfly, I'll set you free.
Show, you did start out as a barber around 11 years old, right? You started working in the shop?
Yeah, about that. I get older every year. No, I was about 10, 11, yeah.
Right. During that time, I heard two stories of how you got involved with Freddie Carlone's orchestra.
Uh-huh.
One story was that a friend challenged you to audition, and another story has it that you used to sing for the customers and they encouraged you to audition.
No, I never. I used to sing a little around the barbershop, yes. But Not a lot, you know. The other's kind of true. We were in Cleveland, and somebody said, "Why don't you get up and sing a song?" I said, "You gotta be kidding." So I did, and a couple of weeks later, he sends me a wire, asked me if I wanted the job, and I thought he was kidding. But I joined him. That was, oh God, that was 1931, 32.
Right.
I sound like Methuselah.
Who?
And things have gone pretty well ever since.
Oh yeah. Did you have any musical idols back then?
Then it was Bing Crosby and Rudy Vallee and Russ Colombo, and we all of us who sang in those days, we all tried to sing like them, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Because they were the big stars. And, as it turned out, the years went by, and I became very friendly with Bing, and we'd been friends all for 30 years or so.
You sang with Carlone's band for about 3 or 4 years. And during that time, did you always have in the back of your mind, well, if this doesn't work out, I'll just go back to the shop?
Many times.
Really?
Yeah, because, you know, I had no idea what was going to happen. Never thought anything like this would happen to me, but my wife was very, very strong about it. I did want to go back a couple times. I said, well, I've had enough fun. Let's go home and I'll get a job and go to work. But she saw different. She saw more in my ability than I saw in my own, if you want to call it ability.
Yeah.
But then we stuck it out, and I'm glad we did.
Catch a falling star and put it in your pocket, never let it fade away. Catch a falling star and put it in your pocket, save it for a rainy day. For love may come and tap you on the shoulder some starless night. Just in case you feel you wanna hold her, you'll have a pocket full of starlight. Catch a falling star and put it in your pocket. Never let it fade away. Catch a falling star and put it in your pocket. Save it for a rainy day. For love may come and tap you on the shoulder some starless night. And just in case you feel you want to hold her, you'll have a pocket full of starlight.
Pocket full of starlight.
Catch a falling star and put it in your pocket. Never let it fade away.
Never let it fade away.
Catch a falling star and put it in your pocket. Save it for a rainy day. For when your troubles start multiplying, and they just might, it's easy to forget them without trying. With just a pocket full of starlight, catch a falling star and put it in your pocket. Never let it fade away. Catch a falling star and put it in your pocket. Save it for a rainy day.
Save it for a rainy day.
Save it for a rainy day.
On WCCM Radio 800. Tonight, we feature an interview with Perry Como. He has a new LP out. The album's called Today, features 12 songs, and it was recorded February 2nd and 3rd of 1987. It's on the RCA label. and you can pick that up on cassette, LP, or CD at any one of your local record stores. The album features a few songs, one called Tonight I Celebrate My Love, Bless the Beast and the Children, That's What Friends Are For, and in the first part of our interview, you heard one of the tunes, the song Butterfly, I'll Set You Free. At 27 past 7 on WCCM, we'll take a break and then continue with our interview with Perry Como.
This is Ray English of the Lawrence Hibernians. We're having our annual St. Patrick's
beginning Sunday, March 6.
Now back to our interview with Perry Como on WCCM, the Golden Age of Radio. Thanks for the memories. In 1937, Ted Weems walked into a casino in Warren, Ohio. Is that where he discovered you?
Yeah, he offered me a job. I didn't want to go. I didn't want to leave the guys. We're like brothers with that band. But he said, Freddie himself was the one that said, "Well, you go ahead. You know, we're going to stay in Cleveland, and they mean something." So I went with Weems, reluctantly, but happily now.
You also had a call that same night from Paul Whiteman's manager, right?
Yeah, well, you know, everybody's looking for somebody with a little bit of hair and Italian or whatever, could sing a little. But it was the era that all of us started. Dick Hames and Sinatra and, oh, God, there must have been Andy Williams. And there must have been 25... And the one with the most hair would get the job.
Yeah.
No, I don't know. It was fun.
There was one point during the your tenure with Weems, I'm not sure the year, but a radio station WGN didn't like the way you sang, and they were going to pull you off the radio.
Oh, that was no, it wasn't radio. It was on records.
On records.
Yeah, when I was recording, I recorded something with Ted Weems, and he was recording with Decca. And I happened to sing on one of the records, and the guy said, "No, we don't want that. We don't want him. We just want the band." So Weems says, "Well, you want him, you'll take him. You take him, or you take won't take the band." You know. And he stayed with me, and which I appreciated at the time. I still do. But I was on when we were doing records, making records with Weems. It was kind of fun, you know.
Did you change your vocal style? Did he sit down and talk to you about that?
No. Well, I'll tell you, in those days, we were all trying to sing like either Bing or Rudy Valley or whatever, as kids, you know. But you kind of pull away from it once you start to sing a little, and you start developing some of whatever you have, you know, because it's nice to be number one in your own style rather than number two in somebody else's.
Yeah.
But those things happen. It happened. We've all gone through this transition, and it's something that has to be done, you know. But the more you sing, the more you develop your own little thing, you know.
You came, I was alone. You smile, luring me on. My heart was gone, and you were temptation. It would be thrilling. Never be. can't resist. You are temptation.
After Weems, the band disbanded, you were about to, I guess, go back to the shop when you met a promoter.
Yeah. Well, it's a long way, a long time ago, but yes, he wanted me to come to New York, and I said, well, I don't know. I think I'll just stay home for a while, and I did. But we finally talked about it, and I came to New York, and he wanted to put me in some nightclubs and things. I said, no, no, I don't want that. I'd rather just try to make some records and get on the air and become a little more known than I am. Because when I was with Weems, I was strictly a territory band, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Everybody knew us in Chicago, but you go to Iowa or Kansas City, he didn't know who the hell you were. So I stuck to that, incidentally. I said, no, get me on the air and I'll come. If not... So I started all over again. I went back to sustaining on CBS, 4:30 in the afternoons.
Wow.
But I wasn't a kid, Jim. I was 30-some years old.
Yeah.
So I knew what I wanted to do, and I knew what I had to do. I felt I knew what I had to do, and evidently that was the right decision. I made a decision, and I stayed with it.
Columbia presents Perry Como.
Your 45th year with RCA. You were signed in 1943.
Right.
And for that, do they renew a contract every 10 years? Do you have to renew contracts?
Well,
or?
We're in the throes now of renewing, but I don't know whether I will renew or not.
Mm-hmm.
RCA, because I think I've worn my welcome, and the kids, this kid stuff today, you know. I may just grow a hair and get some initials put on my head. Maybe start a whole new career. But, no, but, you know, it's just what they want. They're buying with their rock and roll stuff, which is okay. I sometimes feel a little sorry for them because they're not exposed to some of the good music, you know.
Yeah.
If you mention Irving Berlin to them or Rodgers and Hart, they say, who? They don't know who you're talking about.
But
we've had our day with our own composers. Now, that doesn't mean that they still don't buy the records. I still do as well now as I did 20 years ago.
Mm-hmm.
Because, you know, you still have the audience. And we do a lot of concerts and things, and they come, and they show up, and we have fun with them.
Do you still enjoy performing live?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, that's a big part of our business, really. Records is fine. Television is fine. But it's nice to go into a theater and see the action right there.
Talking about the theater, in 43, you were signed to a movie deal with 20th Century Fox.
Yeah, that was a big nothing. I didn't like the work, and I didn't have the time for it. And I used to go out once a year. I think I did four pictures, whatever. But they were all pretty bad.
You just didn't like acting, huh?
No, it just wasn't my cup of tea, really, so to speak. I thought I was just wasting time.
Yeah.
But had I lived there and stayed there and developed a character of some kind, maybe I would have enjoyed it. But just to go out and get into some picture that somebody thinks you ought to get, and actually all they were using you for is a little name value that you might have had, you know.
Mm-hmm.
And they did that. And I enjoyed what I did, but not really. I didn't like the work.
Left of summer but a faded rose. The best of times is now. As for tomorrow, well, who knows, who knows, who knows? So hold this moment fast.
Hold it fast.
And live and love as hard as you know how.
You know how.
And make this moment last.
Hold it fast.
Because the best of times is now.
Chesterfield Super Club in 1944. Was that your first radio show?
Yeah. Yeah, that was 7 to 7:15 on, 5 nights a week. Supper Club. Chesterfield
Supper Club. I'm sorry about that. Did you enjoy having your very own show?
Oh, yeah. Well, that's what you work for, you know. Then I adapted doing that for about 8 or 10 years, and I went on with Kraft, and I was on with them for, I guess 10 years or so.
That was in radio?
That was in television.
The television one, right.
Beginning of television, yeah.
Yeah, 48, you, that was real early for television. You had a 15-minute program. Was that...
That's right.
Was that the same setup as the radio show?
Exactly. We used to. It was a kind of a simulcast. You're on radio and television.
I didn't know that.
They would come in with a camera and one camera and just shoot anything, you know, the back of your head, the top of your head. But it was fun. We didn't know what the hell it was. And they asked me about it. I said, well, that's one of those things that it's not going to last very long.
Yeah.
And you see what a great predictor I am.
Do you have any favorite songs? Through the years, you recorded hundreds and hundreds of classics. Do you have any?
I think Till the End of Time, A Prisoner of Love, No Other Love, The Ave Maria. I love those Christmas songs.
Mm-hmm.
There's so many of them, Jim. I couldn't really think of any of some of the names I forgot.
Are in the blue, long as there's a spring, a bird to sing, I'll go on loving you till the end of time. Long as roses bloom in May, my love for you passing day, till the wells run dry and each mountain disappears, I'll be there for you to care for you through laughter and through tears. Disappears. I'll be there for you to care for you through laughter and through tears. So take my heart in sweet surrender and tenderly say that I'm the one till the end of time.
You mentioned some Christmas songs. Is Christmas a favorite time of the year for you?
I think it is. I think it's a favorite time of the year for a lot of people. I didn't do a show last year, but I'm going to do one this year.
All right.
That was our 33rd Christmas show. Last year, because of a few little contractual things, I didn't do one, but I think we'll do one this year.
Yeah, this year marks the 40th anniversary of that 1948 Perry Como TV show.
That's right.
That'll be nice.
Long time.
Do you have any favorite songwriters? You mentioned Irving Berlin and Rodgers and Hart.
Well, there's Harry, and there's so many. Harold Arlen, oh, God. And I like people like Stevie Wonder. I mean, he's written some good songs. Burt Bacharach, good writer. Oh, there's a lot of them around, but our kids, you know, the kids today, they don't know anything about that. All they know is MTV, which is fine. You know, that's their problem. And all they listen to is those MTVs. I don't know what they're doing, but they know what they're doing.
Well,
I think
this new album features some newer tunes. It has the That's What Friends Are For, the Dionne Warwick tune, and what was another? The Wind Beneath My Wings. That's a very nice one.
It's a good song.
Song.
That was sung by a very fine singer. I can't even think of his name now.
The Wind Beneath My Wings.
Yeah.
Lou Rawls and Gary Morse, I think.
Gary Morse is the one I heard sing it. Yeah, he's a good singer. So you know, there's good stuff out there. If you look for it, but you have to really look.
Right.
You blow it.
One question that I did want to ask you, how would Perry Como like to be remembered?
Well, this is not my line, but I love the line, and I'll tell you what it is. I just like to be remembered.
Yeah.
That's it. You know, how would I like to be remembered? I think I just hope that people will remember me.
Do you remember me as I remember you? I know many years have passed, yet I still can't forget the love we shared. Do you ever regret the day
talking to you, and I'm looking forward to the Christmas special.
Well, thank you. Thank you, Jim. And it was nice talking to you, too.
Still the memory lingers in my heart.
audience.
Thanks.
Thanks.
Bye-bye.
To be.
WCCM Radio 800. A couple beautiful numbers here from Perry Como from his new album, Today. By the way, is released on RCA Records. It's 45th year with RCA Records. You can find it in the record stores now on LP cassette or CD if you have one of those compact disc players. Hope you enjoyed our interview tonight with Perry Como. Thanks for the memories. If you did enjoy this one, please send me a letter, and we'll mail it along to Mr. Como, letting him know that people still appreciate the wonderful music that he puts out.
And let all our wildest dreams.
Our address here at WCCM is 33 Franklin Street, Lawrence, Mass., 01840.
Ukuleles are playing, your heart will keep saying, I've found a new home.
Special treat for you this evening in honor of Mr. Como. We are going to feature one of his programs from 1943 on the CBS network, May 20th, 1943 to be exact. It's about 15 minutes long. We'll start that after 8 o'clock. That, of course, will be followed at 8:30 by The Life of Riley. That's our classic comedy tonight. At 9:30 this evening, classic Western series continues with Hopalong Cassidy. I do want to make mention that coming up next Monday night on the Golden Age of Radio, thanks for the memories, Mel Torme will be our featured guest. Two great singers back to back. Perry Como tonight, Mel Torme next week.
And make all our wildest dreams come true.
This is Radio 800 WCCM Lawrence, a Kurt Ghani station for the Greater Lawrence area. It's 8 o'clock.